Satellites have revolutionized our lives in ways we often take for granted. Our digitalized world is increasingly dependent on them, and they are essential for many tasks and technologies we use on a daily basis. Essentially, space is not only a potential theater of operations, but also an important strategic enabler in support of all military domains. Welcome back to Let's Talk About Tech. Last time we talked about space and defense, and today we are once again stargazing by taking a closer look at satellites. Satellites have greatly enhanced our ability to understand and interact with the world around us, and they continue to be an integral part of modern technology and scientific exploration. The decreasing cost of sending up small satellites has meant that the space sector is going through a boom right now. Some reports estimate that 20,000 new satellites will launch by the end of the decade, a conservative number compared to other sky-high projections. To put it simply, the more we rely on space, the more we have to lose. A satellite consists of the spacecraft bus, where all infrastructure such as power supply and communication systems are included. And the payload consists of the specific antennas, transponders, cameras, or what the mission might require. All built to withstand a rocket launch, and then operate in the harsh environment of space without maintenance. There are multiple kinds of satellites in use today, ranging in size and purpose. So some components vary, but there are two key factors that shape the satellite design: power and coverage. The power source is usually in the form of a battery fed by solar panels. A satellite has multiple channels, called communication subsystem, that provide bandwidth and power over designated radio frequencies. The communication subsystem bandwidth and power dictate how much information can be transmitted and how big the ground equipment must be to receive the signal. In recent years, the space scene has seen a democratization of sorts with CubeSats. These cheap, tiny cube-shaped satellites have opened up space exploration to universities, startups, and even hobbyists, sparking a new era of innovation. In November 2023, we marked a milestone as we witnessed the liftoff of the test satellite EMIR-1 on board SpaceX's Falcon 9 Transporter 9 rocket, carrying Saab's first ever satellite transponder. The satellite is part of the development of the next generation automatic identification system, AIS, a communication platform used by ships to share position, speed, course, and other data. Something all larger ships and boats must use. The limited capacity of today's AIS system is unable to cope with growing maritime traffic and new security demands. With space-based capabilities, capacity will significantly increase, enabling secure two-way communication via satellites and providing global coverage compared to today's systems, which are confined to the coastline. All countries with modern defense forces use satellites to enhance and strengthen military capabilities on Earth. From navigation aids to timing, to position and guide certain weapons, to communicate over large distances, or where infrastructure doesn't work, and to gather information by taking pictures of Earth. And as we send up more satellites, the more we need to be able to coordinate and protect them. After all, you need to make sure your expensive satellite doesn't collide with someone else's. And of course, most nations would be very interested in knowing what kind of satellites everyone else has. Picture a busy airport and air traffic control meticulously directing planes to ensure a smooth and safe flow. In space, space situational awareness serves the same purpose. It's an elaborate system of tracking, monitoring, and predicting the positions of all the objects orbiting Earth. This includes satellites, used rockets, and the ever-growing population of space debris. In 2009, two satellites collided in space. It is believed to be the first time two man-made satellites have collided accidentally. This is why space traffic management will be vital as space gets more congested. It increases the complexity of space operations and makes it impossible to safely operate without taking other spacecrafts into account. But as we see more satellites and spacecrafts being launched, we also run the risk of causing a traffic jam and cluttering space with debris. And what exactly is space debris? Imagine a giant cosmic attic filled with discarded satellites, used rockets, and even the occasional wrench lost during a spacewalk. Space debris is the collection of defunct or simply abandoned objects orbiting our planet. But why should we care about them? Well, it's not just a matter of aesthetics. These bits and pieces can wreak havoc up there. Space debris travels at incredible speeds, and when these tiny fragments collide with satellites or spacecraft, it's like playing cosmic billiards. A collision can be catastrophic, creating more debris and endangering astronauts and critical space assets. And then there's the Kessler syndrome, named after the scientist who first proposed it. It's like a domino effect in space. A single collision can trigger a cascade of collisions, creating a dangerous feedback loop where more and more debris is generated. What can we do about this growing mess? One idea is to actively remove space debris. Another approach is to design satellites and spacecraft with disposal plans in mind. Once they've outlived their usefulness, they could be guided to burn up harmlessly in Earth's atmosphere. But it's not just about cleaning up our cosmic clutter. With space traffic management and international collaboration, we can prevent collisions and minimize the creation of new debris in order to protect our satellites. And what's next? Well, the future holds exciting promise. From mega constellations of satellites to ambitious plans for lunar and Martian missions, satellites continue to push the boundaries of what's possible. As space gets more crowded and our reliance on it increases, so does the importance of protecting our assets. As more nations and private companies enter the space race, space situational awareness will become even more vital. It's about keeping astronauts safe and satellites functioning. But it's also about protecting the future of space exploration and all the technologies that depend on it. This has been the second part of our two episodes on space. But now we turn to you and ask you to be co-creators. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe and let us know what you would like us to dig into next. If you're not familiar with Saab, check out saab.com/space and learn more about what we do, both in space and on Earth. Let's keep talking. Let's talk about tech.